Hello friends, welcome to this video session. The topic that we are going to cover in this session is early attempts at classification of elements. There are 118 elements known at present, and it is very difficult to study the properties of all these elements separately. So, all the elements have been divided into a few groups such that elements in the same group have similar properties. We will now describe the various attempts which have been made to classify the elements from time to time. In the year 1817, Johann Wolfgang Dubereiner, a German chemist, tried to arrange the elements with similar properties into groups. He identified some groups having three elements each. So, he called these groups triads. Dubereiner showed that when the three elements in a triad were written in the order of increasing atomic masses, the atomic mass of the middle element was roughly the average of the atomic masses of the other two elements. For example, take the triad consisting of lithium, Li, sodium, Na, and potassium, K, with the respective atomic masses 6.9, 23.0, and 39.0. The average atomic mass of lithium and potassium is approximately equal to the atomic mass of sodium. You will find that groups B and C form Dubereiner triads. Now, let's discuss why was it not accepted widely. Dubereiner could identify only three triads from the elements known at that time. Hence, this system of classification into triads was not found to be useful. In 1866, John Newlands, an English scientist, arranged the then known elements in the order of increasing atomic masses. He started with the element having the lowest atomic mass, hydrogen, and ended at thorium, which was the 56th element. He found that every 8th element had properties similar to that of the first. He compared this to the octaves found in music. Therefore, he called it the law of octaves. It is known as Newlands' law of octaves. In Newlands' octaves, the properties of lithium and sodium were found to be the same. Sodium is the 8th element after lithium. Similarly, beryllium and magnesium resemble each other. We will now discuss the drawbacks of Newlands' law of octaves. 1. It was found that the law of octaves was applicable only up to calcium, as after calcium, every 8th element did not possess properties similar to that of the first. 2. It was assumed by Newlands that only 56 elements existed in nature, and no more elements would be discovered in the future. But later on, several new elements were discovered whose properties did not fit into the law of octaves. 3. In order to fit elements into his table, Newlands adjusted two elements in the same slot, but also put some unlike elements under the same slot. Also, cobalt and nickel are in the same slot, and these are placed in the same column as fluorine, chlorine, and bromine, which have very different properties than these elements. Iron, which resembles cobalt and nickel in properties, has been placed far away from these elements. 4. With the discovery of noble gases, the law of octaves became irrelevant. 5. Thus, Newlands' law of octaves worked well with lighter elements only. Before we end this discussion, we can observe that Duveriner's triads also exist in columns of Newland's law of octaves. For example, the second column of Newland's classification has the elements lithium, sodium, and potassium, which constitute a Duveriner's triad. So friends, in this video, we studied the early attempts at classification of elements. In the next video, we will learn Mendeleev's periodic table.